To help better understand the safety rules for handling oxy-fuel equipment, let's begin by reviewing the fundamentals of combustion. Well, in order to have combustion, you need three basic elements: fuel, oxygen, and kindling temperature. And if any one of these elements isn't present, combustion will not occur. Let's take a look at how a common match burns in relation to the triangle of combustion. The fuel for combustion is the sulfur on the match head. The sulfur has a very low kindling temperature, which is obtained by heat from the friction that's created when the match is rubbed across an abrasive surface. The oxygen needed for combustion is available in the air we breathe, which is about 21% pure by volume. The process of cutting steel is actually the same. It's a burning process. But for steel to burn, you need more than simple atmospheric oxygen. You need to achieve the extremely high kindling temperature that can only be produced in a very pure oxygen environment, which is then mixed with a fuel gas. And that means oxygen of greater than 92% purity needs to be applied to the steel in order to heat it to its kindling temperature, which is approximately 2200 degrees Fahrenheit. Let's take a look at a simple demonstration of how the purity of the oxygen can affect the kindling temperature of steel. Notice how this piece of steel wool burns using this small candle and atmospheric air. Now, let's see what happens when pure oxygen is introduced into this combustion process. As you can see, the greater the oxygen purity, the faster and hotter the fuel will burn. High purity oxygen also has another effect. It lowers the temperature at which all fuels will start to combust.